morning, gang. It's Tuesday, the 21st of February, 2017. Now, we're recorded again today. We did try and do a live show this morning, but once again, more problems with the camera, and it's all to do with this new camera, and I just cannot get it to work properly. So before we do the next live show, I'm probably going to go back to the original camera, which works perfectly, doesn't it? We have like to have perfect pictures. I gave up this morning. I really gave up this morning. It was all going terribly wrong. But here we are, boys and girls, with a recorded show this morning, as it used to be. And you know, I remember a couple of years ago, I had exactly the same issues with the live stuff. It's a lot harder. It's actually a lot harder to do a live show and have everything video-wise and have everything working perfectly than it is to do a recorded one. It really is. It can be a nightmare. It works for a while and then it goes wrong again. So we'll leave that for a while, OK? Hello to Wendy this morning, who sent a little message from yesterday's show, who said, I enjoyed the show yesterday. Some interesting topics, especially about the memory erasing. Now, you may remember we were doing a show yesterday. We were talking about, would you have bad memories erased? You know, on the outset, it sounds a very good idea. There's certainly some bad memories in my head I'd like to completely forget. You know, generally in my 20s. That was a bad time for me, my 20s. Anyway, Wendy says, there are certainly some things I would like to forget completely, especially during the time of my child and teenage years. But those memories are due to the mistakes of others. As for my own mistakes, she says, maybe because of the feeling of guilt associated with those mistakes. However, to forget my own mistakes would mean I would probably make the same again. Now, that's the thing, you see. There must be one or two of you out there who remember those terrible mistakes they made in their younger days. And for younger, I kind of include everyone under the age of 30, you know. I think you're young right up to the age of 30. After that, you're an old git. I mean, I'm sorry, lovey, you are, dear. But I, you know, I wouldn't want to make those mistakes again, would you? Terrible mistakes I made. She says, pity I missed the live show, would have phoned in. Maybe there was a reason and I would have said too much. Saved me from another mistake. Oh, I know, dear. Yes. I mean, I don't make mistakes at all anymore. As you well know, I am perfect. Absolutely perfect. So thank you very much for that, Wendy. I was listening to the radio last night on the way in to work, which was a nice little karaoke night last night, I have to say to you. Very busy, some new faces once again. And we had the lovely Brandon turn up last night. You might have seen the karaoke stream last night. Brandon was the young lad. Little blonde spiky hair, and he's got a really deep voice. Oh, much deeper than mine. And Butch, dear, oh, I'm going to sneeze. Is it sneezing time today? We might have a sneeze. We haven't had a sneeze on air for a while, have we? Not had a sneeze for a while. And so Brandon sung last night. Unfortunately, there was someone making derogatory comments on the messages that come up next to the karaoke show, which I do remove as soon as I see them. OK, I don't know who you are. I don't care who you are, friend or not. Please do not make derogatory comments about my lovely karaoke singers. It's karaoke, remember that. Not a concert at the Royal Albert Hall. Some good singers, some bad, but that doesn't matter. It's all about having a go. That's what it's all about. And we have fun. You know, while you're sitting there, sad little old person sitting there on your little mobile phone or tapping away, sitting at home on your own, we're all together in a big bar having fun. So up yours, dear. Up yours. If I do see bad comments, if I miss bad comments and you see them, please send me a message. I remove them straight away, OK? So, as I say, very nice night last night. I think we had 24 singers in the end, which means no one sung more than twice. I think one person sung three times last night because it then comes round again, you see. So it starts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there you go, 1, 2, 3, 4, and whatever, and so on and so forth. That's how it works. But on the radio last night, on LBC, on Monday nights, they have a solicitor type legal person that you can ring in. Each night on LBC at 9 o'clock, it's in the Clive Ball show. He has a different thing. I think he has a health person on Wednesdays, and you can call in. Oh, hello. hello. My friend has a little bit of a problem. Yes. You can ring up for that one. He has a consumer expert. I think that's on Sunday night. Thursday night, he has a bloke talking about housing and mortgages, that sort of thing. And Monday nights, he has a solicitor on, and you can ring in with various different things. And there was a couple of really, I mean, I have to say, I thought they were really stupid questions. Of course, you know, if you don't know the answers, they're not stupid questions, are they? So perhaps that's a little bit harsh. We don't like to be harsh on people. We really don't. But anyway, so two calls came to mind last night, which I've written down from memory. Don't be thinking I had this on the ear, you know, on the steering wheel, writing down, which I've seen before. Yes, some terrible driving. And I gather, now, did I bring this story up to read for you today? Let me just double check this here. Hang on a minute. I hope I did. No, is it? Oh, yes, there it is. Good news today, boys and girls. From today, drivers now face 6 points and a £200 fine if they're caught using their mobile phones at the wheel when a new law comes into force. It's next week. Next week this starts, so that must be, is that March? I guess that's March. Oh, wrong picture of Barry Mann. Oh, that's fallen down, isn't it? The tape's come off. That must be starting next, that, so that's starting next week. Lawbreakers will be punished twice as much of before with previous legislation issuing motorists with just 3 penalty points on their licence and a £100 fine. Now, in more serious cases, police officers have powers to prosecute drivers for careless or dangerous driving. So that is good news. I think that is excellent news. But is it going to stop people doing it? You may remember, a couple of weeks ago, I've caught three people watching the bloody television while they're driving. Honestly. And they don't even hide it. It's not like down there, you know, glance down. And it's up there on the windscreen. And I can absolutely see moving television. Two of those were football matches. Oh, you know what the blokes are like with their football. I've got to go and watch the match. Got to wait. It's their life. Seeing a load of pansies kicking around a little ball on a green field for £8 million or whatever they're getting. It's ridiculous. But they're watching it on their bloody televisions, dear. On their mobile phones. Next to them in the car. And what are they going to get fined? Much more than that, I hope. Anyway, so I've got this radio show on. And there were two marriage-type questions that rung in the solicitor. Here's one of them. So a woman, she rings in. This woman, she says, so she's chatting away. And generally, the people asking the questions, you've got to draw the question out of them. They go on and on and on. Honestly, and they don't get to the point. Now, I can't bear people that do that. They go on and they don't actually get to the point. So last night, she rang in and she says, thank you for taking the call. I'm going to get some inheritance tax. And I just wanted to know, would my husband be entitled to that? So the bloke's asking her, well, yes, he would be entitled to that. What do you mean? Would he be entitled to that? She says, well, I wanted the inheritance tax. She's coming into some inheritance. Sorry, incorrect. I'll start again. She's coming into some inheritance from someone. And she wanted to know if she then paid off her mortgage, her and her husband's mortgage, with this inheritance tax, would the husband then have a claim if something went wrong on the house because it was her inheritance tax? And he said, well, of course, because you're married. So anything coming in belongs to both of you. Now, this is interesting. This is interesting. I mean, why would you think otherwise? She says, oh, he says, why do you ask? He said, well, she says, I'm not quite sure how my marriage is going at the moment. So I don't know. I thought I'd better ask. And he says, well, my advice to you is sort your marriage out first. Do not take that inheritance. It's the worst thing you can do because apparently there's a pot, you know, there's like the married pot of everything. house, money, clothes, knickers, pants. It's all in this big pot, right? And if you're a married, you share all these things. And whatever's coming in is shared. Don't take any notice of that saying, what's mine is mine and what's his is mine. That's a load of old rubbish, that is. It's all in the one pot. You legally, it's all both of yours. Okay? And the bloke says, he says, if I were you, I wouldn't be taking any inheritance yet until you've sorted your marriage out. If that marriage is going to break down, then the last thing you want to do is put a load more money in it before that happens, because you'll have to share it. Oh, dear. We don't want to share, do we, dear? No. And I just found it a bit strange that someone wouldn't realise that. Another thing he said, and this surprised me, you know this business of common law wife or common law husband, if you're not married, do you know that's a load of old twaddle? It doesn't exist. There is no common law wife or common law husband. You're either married or you're not married. And I didn't know that. I thought, you know, say I had someone moving here and they stayed with me for, I don't know, 10 years, whatever that would be. That doesn't mean they're my common law wife or common law husband. That doesn't mean anything like that. There's no such thing. No such thing at all. So I found that interesting as well. So that was one call. Another call came in. This was a man who was married and wanted to know if he bought a house in his own name without his wife being on that, would they have any claim if they split up? And the solicitor said to him on the phone, he said, well, yes, of course, because you're still married. And the bloke says, even if it's just in my name? He said, well, yeah, because you're still married. You're still married. Everything that you both have belongs to both of you in law. And again, the solicitor says, well, why are you asking this? Well, I'm not sure if my marriage is going to last much longer. And the solicitor says, well, is it or isn't it? You know? And the bloke says, well, no, I don't think so. He said, well, my advice to you is don't buy a house. Don't do anything like that. Don't start buying things and bringing things into the marriage if you think it's going to go wrong. How stupid can you be? I mean, it sounds pretty obvious to me, doesn't it, you? So that's very good, that is. Do have a little listen to that. It's on the Clive Ball Show on Monday nights on LBC. You can get that right across the UK. And internet radio as well. Just type in lbc.co.uk and you'll come up. It's very interesting. 9 o'clock he does that one. That's the solicitor phone-in thing. LBC on Monday nights, okay? Another thing that I heard on Sunday night in LBC, a guy called Marcus Collins is one of the presenters on there. He's an excellent show, a really, really excellent show. And he was saying all this to do with the business rates, you know, in this country they're about to increase business rates to small businesses, which I'm sure will close a lot of them down. And he says, conspiracy theory here. With all this going on, all this automation going on now, right? Soon you won't actually have to leave your house, will you? And it's almost like us going back to the caves, where we all lived in caves and didn't go out much. Only get something to eat, that was about it. Now, you can ring up and have virtually anything delivered to your house. Whether it's a pizza, you know, shopping. Who ever thought there would be loads of little vans going around delivering shopping to you? Think 10 years ago, that didn't exist, did it? Sainsbury's and Ocado, Waitrose, Tesco's, Asda, all these little vans going around all the time. You don't need to leave the house to get your shopping. If you want to buy a new television, perhaps. Furniture. Again, online, tap in a few keys, bang, the next day it arrives in a little cardboard box. Hundreds and hundreds of little vans delivering stuff in cardboard boxes to the nation, day in, day out. That didn't exist. 10 years ago. Yeah, we had the post office. That was it. Now and again, you know, maybe once a month even. Once every 2 months, you might get a little box in the post, mightn't you? Let's go back further than that. 15 years ago, how many parcels did you get through your letterbox? How many parcels did you have delivered to your house 15 years ago? Many? Any? Maybe one or two on your birthday, couple at Christmas. That was it, wasn't it? We never used to get all this stuff in the post. We used to have to go out to a shop and bring it back in a car, on a bus, on a bike, something like that. Now, you push a button, the next day it arrives. Sometimes hours later. What's the Amazon Prime? Don't they deliver in 6 hours or something like that? How do they do that? I think it's a shame in a way. But it's like someone very high up doesn't actually want us to leave the house anymore. Do you not think so? You may say, well, what about exercise? And well, I mean, maybe the government will give us all our own gym soon in our house. We won't have to do out and do that. We'll just go around on one of those bikes watching the latest Jeremy Kyle show. And with automation as well, even if you do leave the house, you won't need to drive anywhere. There'd be just these automatic cars and buses going around all over the place. Hop on one. You haven't got to do anything. You've got to think. No one will have to think anymore. The only thoughts you've got to come out with is, okay, push a couple of buttons, a little automatic car will arrive at your door. You'll open the door, close the door, and then just fold your arms and I don't know what do you do with yourself all the time? Play computer games? Get bored? And you do wonder if they actually want us to leave the house anymore. It'll be a very strange thing, I think, in 20 years' time. I mean, there's already plenty of people who don't leave the house now. They just sit there in front of the telly, getting fatter and fatter, playing computer games, watching Jeremy Kyle. That's all they do. Now and again, I just got to go and pop out now. Better go do some exercise, walk around the room once, sit back down again and watch some more telly. There's plenty of people like that now. I think that will only get worse as people don't have jobs and things like that to go to. Because that's the other thing, of course. Now, my dear neighbour next door, he does a lot of exercise. They're always out on their bikes, my neighbour and his lady and all that. But he works from home. More and more people are working from home. You don't need to leave the house. You don't need to leave the house to go to work, to go shopping. You don't need to leave the house to go to the cinema for your entertainment. It's all on Sky or something like that. Or if you're tight like me, Freeview. I don't mind waiting 6 months for a film to come out. It doesn't bother me. I haven't got to see it as soon as it comes out. You haven't got to go out for your entertainment. You don't have to leave the house anymore. But is there someone important up above that doesn't want us to leave the houses anymore? And if not, why not? Why would that be? Any ideas? Put a little message under here if you can come up with the answer to that one, because I don't know. It's all very strange and mysterious, yes. By the way, don't worry about the disappearance of the live show today. It will be back, don't worry. But I'm going to work on that. I'm going to have a little bit of work on the thing to sort it all out before we do that again, all right? Now, however, after telling you that you should be, that we might well be staying in a lot more than we used to, what about this if you can get out? The world's first hover bike is here. Oh, yes. This is in this morning's Daily Mail. Hoversurf, the manufacturer behind the incredible technology, have built a single-seat aircraft capable of lifting a person into the sky with full passenger control. Now, before I carry on with that story, I've got to say, when I've seen these drones, you know, going up, and they seem very flat, don't they? They don't really hover, move around a bit like that at all. They do seem very, very easy to control. And I was thinking a couple of years ago, surely they could be able to make like a mobile flying car in the same way as one of these one of these little drones with the four fans around them. Are they fans? You know, blades going. One on each corner they've got. Well, the picture in this morning's Daily Mail looks exactly as I thought it would be. That is exactly how it is. It's a bloke sitting in the middle and four fans, one on each corner. And it looks ever so easy to control. Hover Surf, they're called. The Scorpion 3, that's the name of the product, merges a standard motorbike design with a drone quadcopter. Okay, one of those drones. Drone quadcopter technology to allow riders to manoeuvre in the air as if they were riding a bike out for... Oh, I'd love this. Oh, well... I suppose it would be a bit scary at first. But you've got to go, you know, I wouldn't want to go so high. But you have actually got to go so high to allow for mistakes. Because if you're near the ground and you make a mistake, bang, you're back on the ground again. Damage the Scorpion 3, wouldn't you? I'd love that. Go to work on a quadcopter. Flying over the traffic in King's Cross. Creators say the Scorpion 3 can carry 19 stone in weight. So 30, 14, 15, 16, 17. So I'm 6 stone under that. Way under that. It'd be easy to lift me. Maybe not some of you, but it'll lift me all right. Just. It can carry 19 stone while hitting at speeds of 30 mile an hour. I'll be at work in an hour. And reach an altitude of 33 feet. Oh, I don't know if I want to go that high. Oh, God. What if it goes wrong? It comes crashing to the ground. It can stay airborne for 27 minutes. Oh, I won't quite make it. Maybe I could get a bus for the last part of the journey. I don't know. The quadcopter is available for just $150,000. Money, money, money. An inbuilt safety mechanism limits the maximum speed and altitude of the aircraft in order to prevent accidents. The video begins with a rider kitted in protective equipment, mounting hovercraft and starting the rotary engines. Are they electric? Does it say it's electric? Doesn't say if it's electric or petrol driven. As the propellers pick up speed, the aircraft rumbles into life and tilts forward and the rear of the body lifts up. However, creators, HoverSurf creators, want to provide flight in the hands of amateur and professional navigators. While it's currently seen as an extreme sports thing, it's hoped that the transport will one day realise its full potential and replace cars as the go mode of transport. Well, you see, I'm not convinced cars will be replaced. It would be very, very... Say they could bring this quadcopter thing out today. It would be very, very silly to stop all the cars and put... Because you'd just have the same problem again, wouldn't you? Too many in the sky. How about keeping half the cars on the road and putting half of them in the sky? That would work. You can't have everyone using the same mode of transport. Can you just imagine, if everyone suddenly gave up their cars tonight and went to work tomorrow on public transport, wouldn't be able to do that. There's no way you'd all be able to do that. In a similar way, if everyone stopped using the buses and the trains tomorrow and all decided to get their cars out, that wouldn't work either. You've got to spread it out. Spread it out, dear. Some on the road and some in the sky. This month, BMW unveiled a prototype flying motorbike concept called the Hoverride as well. The growing trend and developments in the world of drone technology could lead to a revolution in everyday transportation. I'd love that. My little fans going around. Up we go! Oh, would you get wet, though? That's the thing, because it doesn't look covered up. It'd be like those poor motor... I always feel very sorry for motorcyclists, don't you? Going around there in their tight leather skin stuff, dear. Oh, it's too much. There was a young lady walking down with her tight leather trousers on the other day. Last night, actually, on the way home. Good news! Good news, boys and girls. Last night, I visited the BP petrol station on the way home and only bought vegetables. No crisps! Round of applause for me. Thank you very much. And the reason I was able to do that, I'll tell you how I was able to do that. I was talking to my friend Adam the plumber on the way back. Now, he's lost, I think it's a stone and 6 pounds with Slimming World. Last week, he put on half a pound. I think he put on half a pound last week, but he knows what went wrong. And that's not to say that he has failed. You know, because there's always people waiting to tell you that you've failed, isn't there? There really is. He simply just fell off for a moment. You get it back again. It's no problem at all. Why do people... I bet people said to him, oh, I knew you wouldn't be able to keep it up. I bet they're like that. No, you shouldn't be like that. In fact, the whole weight thing, I know we joke here. I do have a bit of a joke here about fat and all this, that and the other. I consider myself fat. You know that. It's no use you sending me private messages. Oh, Chris, you don't look fat. I am. I'm overweight. I know that. But I think sometimes one of the worst things you can do is go on at people like that who are a little bit overweight. It really, really gets them. Why do you want to do that? No, well, why would you want to do that? Whenever I mention people's size or anything, it's all in a jesting sort of way. I am including myself in this sort of thing. I might actually stay still. Oh, there we go. Oh, God, here we go. Terry H. loves it when I sneeze for some reason. I don't know why that is. But yeah, you know, I do it in a jesting sort of way. And I include myself in those things. But if you're saying it in a nasty way, then it's not good. And it can really, really put people into a terrible depression. Talking about their weight. I've had it for years. You know, I've been, oh, this is my fat friend or something like that. It really upsets me. I don't say anything. But when people start going on about your weight, you know, and these are usually stick thick insects who do it. And then 5 years later, you see them and they're fatter than you. Good. So you remember that, boys and girls. Anyone calls you fat and they're skinny, just keep that in your mind. Make a little mental note of it or write it down in your diary so that when they get fat as well, you can bring it up again and make them feel just as bad. Yes, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, and a nail for a nail. Might be wrong, that one. All right. Messages from yesterday's show, boys and girls. Joanna says, the evening walk you had the other day is a wonderful and serene. I like to go for a nighttime walk if I've got a night off. I'm off tonight, actually, Tuesday night, so I'll go for a nighttime walk later on. She said, but the crisps, oh, Chris, giving up for Lent is a fabulous idea. I also give up for Lent and feel extremely guilty if I go against what I give up. Guilt is sometimes good. Yes, because we got Lent coming up. And that is from next Wednesday. Not tomorrow. Next Wednesday is Lent. So if you want to give something up, perhaps you had a New Year's resolution and it didn't quite work for you. Well, you have a second opportunity, boys and girls. Lent starts next Wednesday. Going for me are the crisps, the biscuits and the bread. Okay, that's going to be knocked on the head for me. Joanna says, I would never erase bad memories from my mind. I believe that I learned a lot about myself and also learned important lessons from them. That's not for me. So there we are. Simon Keane says, Wetherspoons do have discos. We were talking about Wetherspoons. I didn't think they had any entertainment at all on in there. But they do have discos and karaoke's only in selected ones, okay? And on the subject of supermarket booze, which I've always said was the main killer of some of the pubs in this country. Supermarket booze up here, they get hammered till 10:30, then pile into the clubs, hammered, start trouble, the nightclubs get the blame, government needs to stop them selling cheap beer. Unfortunately, it never happened, Simon. The supermarkets always seem to get their own way. They won't tell them now to stop selling booze. That won't happen. I think it should happen, but I really don't believe it will. So thank you very much for that, Simon. And good. Let me just... that's it. All right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. It's birthday time on United Kingdom Talk. Happy birthday today to the lovely Reverend Ted Woodroffe. Woodroffe. Have you got your surname? Woodroffe. I guess that's about right, is it? 55 today, just a
got cut off then.
Happy birthday to the Reverend. Happy birthday today to Paul Boone, who's 48 years old today. Happy birthday, Paul. To Kiko Aguilar. Don't say your birthday, Kiko. Happy birthday to you. Now, where are you? Where is Kiko? Let me see. Oh, you're from Brazil. I thought you looked a little bit foreign there. Happy birthday to you, my darling. And also happy birthday today to Michael Wisocki, who's 48 today. He does tarot cards and all that sort of thing. So happy birthday to you all, boys and girls. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Reverend Paul, Kiko and Michael. Happy birthday to you. All right? Enjoy your birthday, boys and girls. I'll be working a little bit on the camera business again a little bit later on. And I think it's very likely we'll go back to the original camera, which will be a little bit closer. I'll try and move it back further. If I put a smaller shelf up, that might help as well. Thank you very much for watching and listening on this Tuesday. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.